an arm with a pain associated to the numbness and interstitial. This exam is for the signing and C6 paresis. As in medical treatment, she had physiotherapy and two fasted joint injections plus epidural steroid injections. MRI shows C5, C6 disc lesion, B1, and with a fragment in the right, left side fragment. The surgical technique is similar to lumbar in terms of you can do anything without drilling. You have to first drill the cranial lamina, then identify the caudal lamina, then open the lumbar, and then do a minimal acetate in terms to not have problems. C5 lamina. He uses this dissector to identify the border of the lamina. This is a 2.5 millimeter drill with a lateral protection, and it's pretty safe. The technique is the same to lumbar. The difference is more psychological because you are working near the myelin and the space is very small. This is the facet, the design facet. The idea is not to drill the facet. And it compares with the micro branch with the Carrington branch. Here we are watching the caudal lamina. Be careful in the caudal lamina because the insertion of the joint of lamina is pretty close to the border of the lamina. That's why you use the Carrington branch. Here we can see the nerve and the myelin score there. At 12, the myelin traversing, perpendicular, you have the nerve root and the facet. This is a dissector of 2.5 millimeters dissector, and we can see the bulging. And we say you use same instruments, the micropunch, the scissor, to open the joint and the animal. And obviously, you should be very, very gentle. The myelin don't resist any compression or squeezing. 2.5 millimeters project, and the idea is to remove the fragment very carefully, very tenderly. As you can see, I don't introduce the project into the disc.
You want.
Take this and do a more circular movement below the nerve. If you see closely, there is a red tear. She didn't have any post-operative problems, no symptoms, no nothing, no pain. But I show you this because it's a very demanding and challenging procedure. This is a post-op MRI, 1 month after surgery. You can see no damage to the facet joint, no disc protrusion, only this small fragment without any compression into the nerve root. And in the CT scan, you can see how minimally invasive it is in surgery. Obviously, we are comparing this procedure with